Hi. Good morning, everyone. This is Pooja, and I work as a senior product manager at the Nudge Foundation. We just heard Professor Niharika speak about the importance of skilling, and she said that skilling is not just about finding a job, but it is more about long-term viability of and sustainability of whatever you've learned, right? And how do you make decisions with the kind of skilling that you've received? It's also about perfection. And today we have with us a panel, a very interesting panel. I'm so excited to actually host this panel. We have with us youth who've actually experienced skilling, right? They've gone through the skilling programs in our country, and they're going to share with us what they've learned and how have the skilling programs actually helped them both in their life as well as in their career. So to start with, I'm going to ask a question to Neha. Neha, tell me about yourself. Tell me about what you were doing before you took up the skilling program, and what were you skilled in, like through the skilling, which skilling program were you part of, and what did you get skilled in? Yeah, just introduce yourself.
So hi, good morning everyone. My name is Neha Chande. I have competed at the World Skills 2015 competition. So basically, I am a cosmetologist. I'm a certified cosmetologist. 2011, I think I finished my. I think it's called CNESCO. It's the world's biggest certification that you can take up for beauty and cosmetology. So that's what I finished. I think I did this post my, when I was 18 or 19 years old. That's all. I was too young, I would say the right age to start your skilling journey or your career path. So yeah, I did that course, that I did a lot of other certifications in the same stream, like the aesthetics, the cosmetology thing. Post that, I got into WorldSkills International. So all of us know WorldSkills is the biggest skilling Olympics. So you know, these days the Tokyo Olympics is training a lot, and we are listening about the golds and silvers and things that the country is earning. Skills are not that known yet, but yeah, we were among the first generation of winners who got gold and medal of excellence for the country. So definitely, like the initiatives, what is happening right now, like new people have started doing this. I'm sure even Skills will have this the same platform that Olympics has right now.
Right. You started your skilling journey at the age of 18 to 19. What really compelled you to take up a skilling program?
Well, actually, Pooja, it wasn't planned at all. Like, you know, in like everybody in the age of 18, 19 thinks to do everything, every possible thing in this world. So just a small thing, okay, let me utilize my vacation, made me take up a small beauty program. And that went on to be a really serious thing ahead. So yeah, it was, I think, planned by the destiny and not.
Got it, got it. Thanks, thanks, Neha. I'm going to ask my next question to Rachna. Rachna and Anusha, both of them are together. So both of them have experienced skilling programs through the Gurukul by the Nudge Foundation. I think it's been a year since you graduated from the program, Rachna and Anusha.
Yes.
If I have to understand, what do you know about the program? Why did you take up program like a Gurukul, which is not an institution, it is a residential training program. I know what compelled you. How do you know about this class?
Good morning everyone. Myself Rachana. Actually, I got about Gurukul means while I was completed my exams, I was in my native. So at that time, she's Sudha, I think. So her name is Sudha. She was actually into Gurukul Nudge Foundation, and actually she got a job in HDFC Bank. So I was like there with lazy and all. So she said about this Gurukul, so they'll be giving a training for 3 months and you will be getting a placements also. So by her I got the news and I joined here by that's all.
Right. Are both of you in Bangalore right now?
Yes, ma'am.
Where are you from, Rachna and Anusha?
Ma'am, I'm from basically I born and brought up in Bangalore itself, Yelahanka. So from 7 years I'm staying in Chikbalapur district, ma'am.
Chikbalapur. And Anusha, what about you?
And I'm from Nagpur, Karnataka, ma'am. It's a bagel.
Right. So for you to come to Gurukul, to take up a job in Bangalore, both of you are working in Bangalore as well. One Solution is where you work.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm sure there would have been challenges back at home in Kanishka.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, ma'am. We faced many, ma'am. Actually, starting when we got a placement through Gurukul is a Kannada Matrimony, ma'am. So due to that pandemic, we didn't able to join. Actually, we went native. So lockdown was started, ma'am. So again, it was very difficult for us to find job. We have called for customer care also and all. And again, from the Kannada Matrimony recruiter, we have joined in 1.1 Solutions. It was difficult to find PGs and all, ma'am. We faced a lot and finally we are settled now.
We'll come back to more of the challenges that you have faced. Let me just go back to Himani now.
Okay.
Himani,
good morning.
Tell me about yourself. Tell me about the what you're pursuing right now. What are you working as right now? And why have you chosen this particular career path for yourself?
Okay. So in 12th, I was a science tech student. And I just heard a term architect. And that was like that strike me that I have to do architecture anyhow and I have to be an architect. And I started my journey from there. I appeared for AIEEE, but unfortunately I was unable to join the colleges. So then I got to know that I can do interiors and architecture diploma as well. So I did my diploma in interiors first, and then I got to know that there's MBIT college. So I started applying for that college. I appeared for the exam and I had joined the architectural assistantship course. And then luckily from that college, I got placed at Delhi Metro Rail Corporation. So I'm an architect at DMRC at present. So I design metro stations. And if you have seen like Pink Line, so I've done all the artwork and interiors in that line, specifically underground stations.
Fantastic. So Himani, the journey or the decision making for you to take up something like this, and especially your diploma in architecture, right? Versus the traditional route of, you know, going through, you know, those long graduation programs as well. What made you think about taking up a diploma?
It's actually, I appeared for AIEEE so that I can go for a full-fledged 5 years graduation. I appeared for it 2 years. I cleared AIEEE, but there were some family issues, so I was unable to continue for the same. So then I got to know that there is a three-year program for architecture as well. And I was so crazy for like being an architect, so that I joined those 3 years program. So I was college topper. That's why I got placed from the college itself for DMRC. After I passed out in 2014. After that, I worked as a Vastu consultant in Asian Paints. And after an year, I got placed from the college itself for DMRC as an architect. So I just wanted to be an architect, Hamesha se. So I was like, I was searching for the things ki kahan se main kar sakti hoon and everything. So MBIT has been an amazing platform for me that I can like pursue my dreams. Yes, I enjoy my job.
That's the best part about you know, skilling. You can actually choose what you want to do, and you really get to do what you're passionate about, right? I'm going to come back to you later in some time. My next question is to Manisha. Manisha, if you could help us understand what you do currently, and you know, what is the skilling program that you were part of?
Good morning, ma'am.
Hi, good morning, Manisha.
Currently, I'm pursuing master's from the Delhi University, and I have also done the diploma in library and information science from MBIT. Mm-hmm. And I got to know about this diploma from the website, and I love the book, so I thought this will be the good one for me, so I go for that.
Understood. And how is the program, since you're studying currently, you know, how is the program? How do you think the current program that you're undergoing is? What are your opinions about it?
Ma'am, I think it will help to enhance the skills to the students and also help to explore the new areas. So this type of program should be encouraged by your by the team you're doing.
What do you really like about what you're experiencing right now about the program?
I think the things you are programming and the you are conducting these type of programs and webinars for students so that they can aware about these kind of things. So I think this is a good one.
Understood. I'll come back to you, Manisha, in some time. I'm going to ask my next question to Abhijit.
Okay.
Abhijit has been part of, has undergone the skilling program by Nadja's Gurukul and is currently working at the Gurukul. Welcome, Abhijit. Abhijit, tell me about where are you from? Why did you decide to go to Gurukul? What are you doing currently? Tell our audience what you're working as currently as well.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. So I am Abhijit, and ma'am, I belong from a very, very backward village, and I don't used to think about my future because I was in that kind of environment, and there nobody is thinking about their future. Still, the people are not thinking about their future. So suddenly, I know about Dhanaj Foundation from Jivika. Jivika is one kind of society which is working for the rural India. So I know about Dhanaj Foundation that there somebody are doing some kind of course and they are giving the job. So I was needed in the job, so I came. So 2018 I came to Delhi, and so when I came to Delhi, I used to think this is something kind of a skill development program where we will learn, you know, how to speak English and how to serve the people like that. But I most have to say it was not just a skill development program. I most have to say it was a life development program. I have learned a lot of things, not just the skill. You most have to say that I have learned the mindset. See, when you live in such a, you know, poor kind of environment, poor kind of environment is not just economy wise, also the mindset wise. So when you come into the, you know, rich environment, mindset wise, so you learn, you see the people and you learn a lot of things. So it's happened to me, and I learned a way of thinking. I most have to say I learned a way of thinking. I learned a lot of things. Whatever I am speaking, I learned from Gurukul only. But more of that skills, I have learned the way of thinking. Okay, and
आपके जो आप जहाँ से आते हो वहाँ पर जनरली जो यूथ रहते हैं आपके कम्युनिटी में करते क्या है वो?
सी मैम, मैं क्या करता था उसी से आपको पता चल जाएगा कि वो लोग क्या करते हैं. तो मैम, सुबह में मैं उठता था, चार दोस्तों को मिलता था, थोड़ा बहुत कभी किसी दिन एक्सरसाइज हो गया तो हो गया, नहीं तो नहीं. मुझे ये एक्सेप्ट करना होगा कि कंज्यूमिंग तम्बाकू इज द बिग प्रॉब्लम ऑफ दैट काइंड ऑफ एनवायरमेंट. And almost we passed our all day like that. We are not doing anything. It's just pass our day while, you know, taking tea and consuming tamaku. That's all. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
एक जब जॉब का नीड था और जब मैं दिल्ली आया वापस, तो सडनली मतलब सब कुछ चेंज हुआ एंड मुझे लगा यार क्या कर रहा था मैं. और तब से जब फिर मैं चेंज हुआ और गुरुकुल में आई वाज अ रेड कैप विनर, तो मैं वहाँ से जो चेंजेस करना शुरू किया, मतलब गुरुकुल जाने के बाद ना मुझे अपने फ्यूचर की चिंता होने लगी, क्योंकि मैं समझने लगा कि व्हाई दिस इज इम्पोर्टेंट. यस मैम.
सो आई वुड लव टू हियर अ लिटिल मोर अबाउट योर एक्सपीरियंस, अबाउट व्हाट यू आर डूइंग राइट नाउ, अबाउट गुरुकुल एज वेल. आई विल कम बैक टू यू इन सम टाइम, अभिजीत.
यस मैम.
I'll come back to you, Abhijit, in some time. I'll ask you some questions in a while. I'll go back to the other speakers for a while. So, Neha, tell me about your peers that have gone through a similar program that you were part of, right? And you got an opportunity to be part of the World Skills, competition as well. But what do you think most of the people who were your peers then are doing right now? Do they have a similar journey as you, or has there been any difference at all?
I think, Pooja, my journey, fortunate enough and blessed enough to, you know, have the World Skills in my life. I mean, it's been almost, 5-7 years now. I'm still associated with them. I'm here talking to you. I think it's a proof that World Skills has mattered so much. Definitely, it gave me a kind of, I would say, a push compared to my other peers, because it kind of limelights what you're doing. It kind of gives glamour. It kind of gives you an acknowledgement for your work. you know, and acknowledgement is not very small. It is at a global platform. So definitely, I'm 27 right now. I own my own business. I have my own cosmetology school in Mumbai, which is like a big thing for somebody into my age. People know me with my name. My industry acknowledges me as a young entrepreneur, as a young trainer. So I remember I started training when I was 20. It was because of World Skills. Like in that age, people are working as a makeup artist or as a sales executive or something of the sort. But because of World Skills, the acknowledgement, because of the name and the fame that it gave me, people had trust. Big brands like the giants in the factory had trust in my work. So I can definitely, World Skills will leverage your performance. It will kind of make you stand apart from the crowd for sure. Like there's no doubt. I think all the credits for what I am right now will go to World Skills for sure.
Yeah. And what are you doing right now? Yeah. A similar opportunity as you, or there is a cutthroat competition there as well. What was it like?
I think all of us are doing well because skills give you livelihood, you know. So even my batchmates or my classmates are doing well in their life. However, I have got a little extra opportunity to get the glamour for what I'm doing right now. Even they are doing amazing. Definitely they are doing amazing in their life. But I'm doing a little better because of this.
What is that one message that you would like to give? I know that you mentioned you have to go for your vaccination, which is why I'm asking you this question. What do you think, like, what is that one message that you would want to give? Because there is passion, there is hard work, and there is a combination of all of this. But to get to a place where you are able to accomplish something at an international level, what is the message that you'd like to give to the youth who are undergoing a similar platform right now?
I think consistency is the key. Being grateful for what you have right now is the key. So just to be thankful to the people you have, for the opportunities you're getting. And just be consistent, keep patience, things will happen, and it will happen at its own time. So you cannot rush anything, right? So just polish your skills, be the best at what you're doing, and you're going to achieve it. That's it.
Awesome. So consistency is the key, is what Neha is saying. Let's move to our next speaker, Rachna and Anusha. We were talking about the kind of challenges that you face, because while it is useful, while a skilling program is useful, how is it that your parents got convinced of you moving from, from your hometown, or even if you were, part of the project, but how did your parents get convinced for you to take up a job?
Yeah, first of all, my brother has taken a training in Gurukul and he referred me so that my parents they said, okay, you can go and you can take a training. So after training, I came to Bangalore and I have taken a training for 3 months. And after that, I have selected in Kannada Matrimony. Okay, so that Kannada Matrimony, after, because of this pandemic situation, we went our native back and we don't have a job that time. And after that, we got a job in a 1.1 solutions. And I'm very proud of that. Gurukul is like given this much of opportunity to achieve something in our life.
Right.
Very proud.
But tell me, if the Gurukul would not have been there in your life, you would not have gone through a Gurukul program. Yeah. What do you think you would have been doing right now?
We will be not here, still studying, pursuing my study.
Still studying back in your hometown. What do you think other people who from your communities who did not join a skilling program like Gurukul, what are they doing right now back in the hometown?
Like they are doing normally, like some of got married and they are studying, continuing their studies. Like I want to say that they lost their opportunity. They have to come back to Bangalore and they have to work here because it's a big opportunity from the Gurukul side. So I just say that they have lost their opportunity and we have used it.
Right. Absolutely. I'll ask my next question to Himani. Himani, tell me about you know, your experience currently of working with DMRC, and what are the challenges that someone faces while they are taking up a job? Like, first day at job can be challenging. Doing a job consistently with an organization for a long period of time, I'm sure it can be frustrating at times. There are different situations that you experience. So talk to us a little more about that, about your experience of working then.
So when I started working after 2014, my first job was Asian Paints. And I really loved that job because I used to go to sites, I used to deal with clients, and I love talking to people and love interacting with them. So that was a very special time for me, I would say. That was a span of 10 months and I had 250 clients. And I used to give them consultation as per Vastu. After that, I joined DMRC, and DMRC is all of a sudden is a very different job. Mm-hmm. It was my dream job, but it is like that you have to sit at office and work. And once the construction starts, and then you can go to the sites and see. And this is a very different experience altogether, what I can say, because designing a metro station is not really very common. Being an architect, you design houses, you design offices, schools, institutions, but you never learn anything related to this in your college time as well. It's just that basic you learn, that how can you design, what you can give your what skills you can use while designing. So that is the thing I used, and it was very tough for me to learn designing a metro station for sure. And I really feel very glad that I'm one of a person that I'm helping people anyhow commuting, because in Delhi, I think this is really very important how you commute, so that it can save your time in a city like Delhi. So I really feel very great that I am a part of such an organization that I can help people commute in a lesser time and safely as well.
And do you see yourself doing this for the next how many years? Like, how do you?
So I've been in DMRC from last 6 years. So I've completed my 6 years in June this year. And starting, it was really very tough for me because I was not meant for such a job, such an organization. But yes, it's a beautiful organization. Like, everyone is very helping. But yeah, I used to I always liked going to sites and interacting with people. But DMRC is not like that. You don't get that chance that you have to interact with people and everything. And of course, it is really very tough to grab things that how you design a metro station, what is the things going on, what you have to keep in mind. You have to keep people in mind that people should not suffer just because of your single mistake, and how you can make the interface of that station easy for people. So my mindset has totally changed now.
Got it. That's amazing. Just, staying in an organization for 6 long years and then consistently, even if there are challenges, waiting for the right opportunity plus giving you 100% at the same time. It's amazing, right? I'm going to ask my next question to Abhijit. Abhijit, abhi kya kar rahe ho? What are you working as currently? And tell me about your, first day of joining a job.
Okay, ma'am. So I really feel very happy and proud whatever I am doing, because ma'am, what I do, जो मैं था और जो मैं बना, उस process के लिए ही मैं लड़कों को लाता हूँ, लोग को admission में, admission department में काम करना, वो भी गुरुकुल के, तो उन बच्चों को लाना, और मैं इसमें बहुत ज़्यादा believe करता हूँ, because ये मेरे साथ हुआ है, मेरे साथ और भी जो साथी थे गुरुकुल में, उनके साथ हुआ है. And I am 200% sure कि slowly, step by step, ये society के अंदर एक बड़ा बदलाव करने वाला है, और मैं पूरी तरह से इसमें विश्वास करता हूँ. और उन बच्चों को लाना मुझे बहुत proud होता है कि जब भी मैं 2-4 बच्चों को enroll करता हूँ, क्योंकि मुझे पता है कि उन बच्चों का life पूरी तरह से बदलने वाला है. So that is why I love my work.
आप जब join किए थे सबसे पहले, आपका पहला job नज में ही था?
जी. तो मैं नज में सबसे पहले मैं एडमिन असिस्टेंट के तौर पे काम किया, और फिर मैं नज का जॉब में लीव कर दिया, क्योंकि मेरे घर पे आना मुझे जरूरी हो गया था, और वो जॉब मेरा दिल्ली में था. फिर वापस घर पे आया, लेकिन मैं कंटिन्यूसली कुछ ना कुछ काम करते रहा, बिकॉज आई टोल्ड यू माइंडसेट वर चेंज. तो उसके बाद फिर मैं वापस नर्स ज्वाइन किया एज अ काउंसलर, ठीक है, और मैं बच्चों को एडमिशन डिपार्टमेंट में गया और बच्चों को इसी प्रोग्राम में इनरोल करना शुरू किया, और अभी मैं एसोसिएट टीएल हूँ इसी प्रोग्राम के अंदर, और मैं ज़्यादा अच्छे तरह से काम कर पाता हूँ, ज़्यादा अच्छे लोगों तक पहुँच पाता हूँ, और जो भी बच्चे हैं जो नीडी है, जो मेरे ही जैसे सिचुएशंस में है जहाँ मैं था, बदलना चाहते हैं, उन बच्चों को इस प्रोग्राम से इनरोल करके मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता है, एंड आई एम फीलिंग वेरी प्राउड टू वर्क विद ऑर्गेनाइजेशन.
लेकिन सी, वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम्स दैट अ लॉट ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस टुडे फेस इज दैट यूथ डोंट स्टे इन जॉब्स, मतलब जॉब जल्दी से छोड़ के चले जाते हैं.
यस,
कि एक महीना, दो महीना, तीन महीना, ज्यादा से ज्यादा छह महीना, एक साल, और एंड द रीजंस फॉर दैट आर डिफरेंट. परहैप्स यू नो घर की याद आ रही है, घर जाना है वापस, मतलब यहाँ पर बहुत ज्यादा मेहनत है, या फिर बॉस ने चिल्ला दिया, राइट? दीज आर सम ऑफ द प्रैक्टिकल चैलेंजेस दैट यूथ फेस.
यस, यस, डेफिनेटली.
टॉक अ लिटिल मोर अबाउट दीज चैलेंजेस. हैव यू फेस्ड दीज चैलेंजेस एंड या व्हाट हैपेंस इन द यूथ लाइफ देन?
डेफिनेटली मैम. सो ये एक तो बहुत बड़ा समस्या है. फर्स्ट थ्री मंथ के अंदर लोग काफी जॉब छोड़ते हैं, और उसका बहुत बड़ा रीजन ये है मैम कि कभी भी उनको हैबिट नहीं हुआ होता है उस तरह के काम करने का, प्रेशर का, और इतना लंबा समय एक जगह बैठने का, ये भी एक बहुत बड़ा प्रेशर होता है मैम. सो ये क्षमता जो है ना हमें गुरुकुल के अंदर थोड़ा डेवलप हो जाता है, तो कंपेरेटिवली जो गुरुकुल के स्टूडेंट है वो ज़्यादा अच्छा फ्यूचर बना पाते हैं कहीं और, कंपेरेटिवली अगर डायरेक्ट कोई ज्वाइन करता है तो. एंड इसके लिए ये जो बदले, इसके लिए हम लोग क्या काम कर रहे हैं कि जब हम एडमिशन्स लेते हैं उस समय ही हम क्या करते हैं, बच्चों को इस तरह से समझाने का कोशिश करते हैं ताकि उनको ये पता चले कि वो एक अपने आप को बदलने के गेम में जा रहे हैं. ये थोड़ा टफ है क्योंकि अभी तक आप जो करते आए हैं वो आप कर रहे हैं, लेकिन अगर आप आगे जो कुछ भी करना चाहते हैं तो उसके लिए आपको टफ गेम के अंदर जाना होगा. एंड हम जब एडमिशन लेते हैं तब से हम उस माइंडसेट को बिल्ड करने का कोशिश करते हैं मैम. एंड उसके बाद हमारे ट्रेनर्स हैं, और उसके हिसाब से जब हम बिल्ड करते हैं तो देर इज लॉट ऑफ पीपल वो अच्छा कर रहे हैं. मैं बहुत सारे पर्सनली लोगों को जानता हूँ जो गुरुकुल से निकले हैं और इस वक्त टीएल है, तो बहुत अच्छा लगता है मैम. तो इस चैलेंजेस को हम यहाँ से थोड़ा थोड़ा टैकल करने का कोशिश कर रहे हैं, एंड वी आर डूइंग मैम.
यस, एब्सोल्युटली अभिजीत. नेहा, कमिंग बैक टू यू, आई हैव अ यू नो आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन. सो because of the pandemic a lot of you know organizations had a setback, a lot of you know businesses had a setback as well, right? How did you cope, because you said you do have a school in Bombay as well, and you're working, how did pandemic really affect you?
Big time, Pooja, because you know beauty and wellness was completely shut, so the first industries to get shut was, so ours was among the first, and we were closed for a long time. I think we opened up in September or October. So it was very difficult, you know, the decision whether I should continue this business or just put a full stop was something which actually broke my heart, because it is just 3.5 years to my business. So if I reduce these 1.5 years, it was definitely a tough time. But I think this particular phase of COVID showed us that how strong we are, how much passion and love I have for this particular business, that I was ready to do anything and everything. I was ready to leave everything just to, you know, continue this and raise this. So I think it was really difficult, because business-wise, we are still coping up, you know. I mean, because the trains are shut, because the mode of travel is shut, so students do not come that fast. Even the clients do not walk in because they are afraid. So definitely, it's very difficult right now also. I'm sure it's going to take quite some time, but yes, it taught me that how much I love it. It gave me more confidence, I would say. It gave me more strength that, okay, I can do this. If I can do it in this phase, I can do it in any phase of my life. So yes, it was difficult, but I think it showed me who are my people. It gave me the real life experience of running a business, being a women entrepreneur. So yeah,
it was. And this is one of the biggest life experiences as well, right? For anyone who's running a business, this is one of the biggest experience of how do you manage through some of these obstacles that come in your way. And if you do have the passion, you know that you are going to sort of continue. Maybe this is just like a break, but you will continue doing that for the longer term.
Precisely. I think we just took a little back step, but I think now we are going to run much more faster. And it's going to be worth it. I think all what we are doing right now is going to be worth it at the end. And absolutely. I'm very optimistic for it, for sure.
Absolutely. That's amazing to hear. Manisha, since you're still pursuing your education and this is, you know, the world is at a stage where there are, you know, there is pandemic and there are opportunities as well. So Manisha, tell me about how do you think, like, what are you planning to do right after you've completed your skilling program or the course that you're taking up right now?
Ma'am, I was thinking to do the internship so that I can learn new things because it is my learning stage. So if I got the opportunity regarding the employment, so this will help my future and career also.
Right. And Himani, absolutely anything that you would have faced because of the pandemic? Was there, you know, has there been any shift in the way you thought or you've been thinking so far? Has it affected in any way at all, pandemic?
Pandemic, I think it did affect our organization. It was a downfall for us that Metro was not operational for months. And of course, it was a downfall for each and every employee working over there. And also for a government organization to work from home is very tough because you have to work on the documents and nothing is on soft copies available and everything. And it was really very tough at that point of time to manage things.
So what are the skills that you had to immediately pick up because of the pandemic? Were there any additional skills or you think whatever, you know, skills that you had were enough for you to sustain even during the pandemic?
It's like when you work in an organization like DMRC or any government organization, you have to be like in touch with the documents and the dates you remember. Once you are in office, you remember you have to check what file and what page and you'll get the data. But while sitting in home and you have to remember all the data, that was really very tough. So for that purpose, I started taking some extra steps that how can I do it. Once I joined back the office, and I know that pandemic was quite long and people were working from home like from last 1 year, but for us it was just for a month and we joined back office so that we can serve people, we can like manage things because it's not really very easy for us, an organization like Metro, to work from home. So I really don't think what work from home is. I don't know about it because I've never done it. So I have to travel and it was really very tough to travel in such a situation like COVID because you are scared for your life as well. And how to travel because there's no conveyance and then borders are sealed because I live in Ghaziabad, I have to travel to Connaught Place, Delhi. So that was tough. Otherwise, it was manageable.
Understood. Rachna and Anusha, my next question to both of y'all. You graduated from the skilling program at Google, right at the time of pandemic, March 2020.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, ma'am.
And jobs, there were like very few jobs available at the time. To even think about being in a city at that time, like tell me about your journey during the pandemic right after you graduated. Where were you? You know, how did you come back and when did you come back? And what was the job still there when you came back to Bangalore or when you were in Bangalore?
Actually, ma'am, we started our journey in Gurukul on December, I think. So up to March, we were there. So starting when we came, we were very fear. Actually, we was in a job need, ma'am. So we were looking for, still we didn't go.
What are the needs? Sorry, before you complete the question, when you say job was a need, like what was the real need? Why did you want
to? Ma'am, because I lost my father in this 7 years he has made. So I am the only one who need to work. So I completed my BCom. So I was searching job in real my native itself. So actually my mom also got an accident. So my brother is studying engineering at that time. So I was the only one to work and to get earn money, ma'am. So I was thinking where to work. So I got a news about this and there will be 100% placement also. So I came in the month of December and so I completed 3 months and even I have a red cap holder also, ma'am. So they gave me a placement in Matrimony. So I was happy that I have got here. Without Gurukul, really, I wouldn't have come here and I have got job at least for now by Matrimony recruiter, I have got job here. So if not, means I would have been roaming here itself, ma'am, in Bangalore doing such a job and all. So really, I'm very proud to say that I am a Gurukul student, man. I worked 1 year in 1.1 salutations. Actually, I was taking a 12,000 salary firstly, ma'am. It was like we need to pay for PG also 4,500. Rest amount will we need to share to our family also. So it was like very difficult to us. So then again started within 1 year, they even provided our incentives also. So due to this pandemic, the process was shut down. So again, I have tried and I got a job in No Broker, and now they are paying me 18,500. So from Monday, it was a joining, ma'am. Actually, we were about 30 people in our batch, I think. So they helped us a lot. Even now, I'm like speaking is fearless, ma'am. At that time, I was having very fear to talk in front of stage. But now I have a lot of confidence.
That's absolutely amazing. That's the confidence that perhaps you would have, even by virtue of being in a job, sometimes you get that kind of confidence. By learning, by being in a group, you get that kind of confidence. And I think just like Professor Niharika, ma'am, had told in the beginning, she had mentioned that how skilling is so useful to even build confidence.
Yeah, ma'am. Yes.
Skilling programs really help you in your long term sustain that sort of confidence as well, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Anusha, tell me about yourself. Where do you see yourself 5 years from now? You know, what do you think will be some of the good things that you'll be doing in 5 years from now, some of the challenges that perhaps you'll be facing?
Yeah, ma'am. In the 1 year itself, I have taken 1 year experience from 1.1 solution. After 1 year, after this second lockdown, I came back Bangalore, and now I am working in a MNC company with a 21,000 salary, ma'am. There I used to get only 12.3. So now I am getting, I used to get 21,000. I am very proud of it, ma'am. And again, like this only, I will get experience, and I want to see myself in a next stage, ma'am.
And what do you think will be some of the reasons why it may or may not happen? Like, what are some of the challenges that you see, problems that you see that can happen in the next 5 years, maybe, in being able to achieve that?
Yeah, ma'am. This one will happen, like how I should tell that, ma'am. Something will come, like family will ask to come back to native, and I have to like convince my family, ma'am.
What are you planning to do to convince your family? Like what is it that you have that will make your family convinced?
If I do a proper job here, like I used to get a proper salary, they will agree to stay here.
Understood. Yeah. I think my last, we are almost like out of time, and I'm going to ask my last question to Abhijit. Abhijit, there are so many youth like you right now who are, perhaps back in your hometown itself, in your community itself, there are a lot of youth perhaps who do not really understand the importance of skilling and understand the importance of staying in a job for you to grow. What is that message that you would want to give to these youth who perhaps do not realize the importance to them?
Yes, ma'am. So, see, there is a lot of people who is saying live in present. Okay, ma'am. So, I just want to share this thing with the people. Yes, please live in present to make your future better. Live in present to make your future better. This is my message to all my friends, ma'am.
Right. Yes. And the ones that who perhaps yes. will be scared of taking up a job, like what do you have to tell to them?
सी मैम मैं उनको यही कहना चाहूंगा, आप कब तक डरिएगा, और जब तक आप डरिएगा जीवन आपको डराती रहेगी. आपको अगर ग्रोथ करना है, आगे बढ़ना है, तो चांसेस लेने होंगे ना. आपको डिफिकल्टीज आएंगी और उसको फेस करना है, तो आप अपने आप को स्ट्रांग करिए कंपेरेटिवली चीजों को छोड़ के भागने से. तो मैं उनको यही बताना चाहूंगा कि सामना करना शुरू करिए, डिफिकल्टीज तो आएंगी. और आपको क्या लगता है कि अगर आप अभी बच गए तो आगे डिफिकल्टीज नहीं आएगी? अगर आप अभी बच गए तो आगे इससे बड़ी डिफिकल्टीज आएगी जो जहां आप नहीं बच पाएंगे. सो अभी से हैबिट क्रिएट कीजिए, ये मैं उनको बताना चाहूंगा मैम. और जो आपने काम के बारे में पूछा था, जो काम मैं कर रहा हूं वही मैं अगले 5 साल 10 साल तक करना चाहता हूं. इसको थोड़ा और लार्ज लेवल पे करना चाहता हूं. ऐसे ऐसे और भी जो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है भारत के अंदर काम कर रहे हैं, उनसे जुड़ना चाहता हूं, और समाज के उन बच्चों को जो रूरल एरिया में है, जो मैं पहले था वैसे हैं आज भी, उनको पता नहीं चल रहा है कि करना क्या है. सी ऐसा नहीं है कि उनका नीड है ऐसा, जैसे हमारा फूड जिस तरह से हमारा नीड है, सो कंज्यूमिंग तंबाकू नीड है ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, आदमी शौक में शुरू करता है और उसमें फिर उस ट्रैप में फंस जाता है, स्टार्ट वो शौक में करता है, कोई नीड नहीं है इसका, ठीक है। बट उन लोगों को बदलना, उनको ऐसे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन से जोड़ना, ठीक है, उन तक, उन लोगों को उस तरह के ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जोड़ना जहां उनका लाइफ में बदलाव आ सके, यही मुझे अपने लाइफ टाइम वर्क करना है। आई हैव डिसाइडेड
फॉर ईच एंड एवरी वन ऑफ यू फॉर जॉइनिंग अस टुडे। इट हेल्प्ड अस रियली अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आर सम ऑफ द skilling programs that exist today, and what are they focus on, and how do you build resilience in yourself despite any kind of shocks that you get? How do you still continue to grow? How do you continue to believe in yourself? Also, how do you continue to persevere and stay consistent through all of this? And absolutely important. So I'm sure all of y'all have sort of decided what you want to do in your career, what you want to do in your life. And hopefully this message has also reached to a lot of you that are watching this program, that there is going to be problem, there are going to be difficulties that you'll face, but each and every one that you saw today has faced that kind of challenges. It's just up to you on how do you decide to face these challenges and not really step back away from it, right? So thank you so much everyone for joining us. Over to you, Sandhilya.
Thanks, Pooja. Thanks, everyone. Thanks for the session. I'll end it right now. Yeah. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.